Hello friends, we will be discussing certain details about how to solve an illustration whereby there is a complete sale of asset, however it is under WDV method. Let's figure it out with an illustration that we'll be mentioning down here for your reference. So when we speak about profit or loss computation on sale of a complete asset, that means there is one specific asset which has been sold out during the tenure or probably the usage of its tenure, and after that you have to calculate whether there is a profit or loss under that specific computation or that specific transaction. In the previous video we have learned about how to utilize the same thing when you are using SLM, that is a straight line method. You are using this under the straight line method. However, now we'll be understanding the same scenario under WDV, that is the written down value method, where you're going to use the same format, the same structure. It's just a different illustration whereby we'll be mentioning all these details under one specific illustration and you will have to solve it using the WDV method. That's correct. The written down value method will be used here just to make sure that you are familiar with both the methods and that there is no computation difficulty or while calculating any kind of transaction details like this under profit or loss computation. So let's start with the illustration first here. We have mentioned in the below illustration that Messrs. XYZ Limited has given the description of their depreciation accounting for the year 2015. We have also mentioned in the bracket that it is for the month of January until December. So the tenure that we'll be calculating or the financial year that we'll be calculating here will start from January rather than the way it starts from April. So from Jan to December, this is the tenure that you have to calculate. So accordingly, all the transactions which are going through should be going through in this specific manner. So if you have to calculate the tenure for 12 months, you have to take from Jan until December for any specific month. This is for the year 2015. Let's go ahead with certain more illustrations on it. We have mentioned the details of the questions that we wanted to refer when we are computing or when we are calculating the details of WDV method. Now we have mentioned down three machines here. Machine one, which was purchased in 1st of April 2013, which was for 20 lakh rupees. Machine two, that was purchased on again 1st of April 2014, which was for 15 lakh rupees. Machine 3 that was purchased on 1st of April 2015, which was for 10 lakh rupees. Now we have calculated, or rather we have been given three machines details. On 31st of December 2015, they have mentioned that the first machine, machine 1, was sold out for rupees 16 lakhs. The rate of depreciation is 10% at WDV method. We have to calculate the depreciation total, that means the total amount of depreciation we have been providing for all these assets since 2013 and value of all these machines after the sale transaction that we have until 31st December 2015. Now, we know that this question has three specific machines out of which one has been sold out. So you have to give depreciation for the other two from 2013 or rather from the date of purchase until December 2015. Accordingly, if you see that we have all these transactions on 1st of April, so make sure that the transaction details for the first year for every machine is tenured or calculated from April until December. Like for the first machine which has been purchased from April, so for the depreciation calculation you'll have to use from April until December. This is the calculation and not from December or not from rather Jan to December. So make sure these errors are not made while calculating the depreciation year for the first year. Second year it's absolutely fine until you reach the date of sale transaction. So make sure whenever these details are supposed to be entered here, a timeline is followed. So be preparing the timeline first and understand how these details are aligning or rather coming up in a structured format. So it will be from an ascending way. Let's figure it out. So we'll be aligning them in a structured format and we'll be figuring out how these details come under in an ascending way. So let's figure it out. So we can see that we have figured out all these timeline details. However, this timeline only includes the purchase transaction. We have to mention an additional transaction which was for sale, which has been mentioned in this question. That means machine 1 that was purchased for 20 lakhs was sold out in the year 2015 on 31st December for 16 lakh rupees. Let's mention that timeline, or rather let's mention this detail in the timeline, and then we'll mark the closure of the timeline itself. Post which, we'll be going ahead with the working part of it. So now that we have mentioned all these details in the timeline, we have have a structured timeline available with us. The next part that we'll be doing here is that we'll go ahead with the working of each and every machine and understand how this working has been calculated under written down value method. Also, whenever you're mentioning these details under written down value method, make sure there is no constant depreciation that is provided here, because under written down value method, the depreciation is calculated every year on the closing balance of the previous year. So this is how you'll be calculating it. Let's go ahead with the working first. If you can see, we have figured out the timeline details first, and then in the working note, we have made it in a structured format. The reason being, you need to understand how every calculation is going on, because this working will be only related to the depreciation part. The sale, profit and loss computation will be coming up in the next sheet. However, let's start with machine one first. Now, if you remember, the cost of that machine was 20 lakh rupees. The tenure is very important here. Hence, we have mentioned that the year 2013, we have purchased it on 1st of April 2013. Make sure the depreciation is calculated on the basis of that tenure itself. There is no, or there shouldn't be any deviation that you have to go through while calculating the tenure of depreciation calculation. So let's make sure the depreciation calculation is done right on the basis of the tenure for which it has been used. Now, if you figure out 20 lakh is the cost of that specific asset, 10% depreciation for the first year. However, it is only for the first year that you have to be considered about while calculating the tenure, because in the next year it will be used for 12 months, considering there has been no sale transaction done for that specific machine itself. So for this month, or rather for this year 2013, while calculating depreciation, it will be 20 lakh multiplied by 10%, however multiplied by 8 divided by 12. The reason being that depreciation is calculated only for 8 months, right, from April until December. So that period has to be calculated and not the whole period from Jan to December, which is the whole financial year for this specific sum. So let's find out the depreciation here and figure out what is the book value as of ending 2013. Now that you figured out the book value for the year 2013 is 18,66,667. How we have calculated it? It is as per the depreciation. The depreciation amount that was figured out for year 2013 for the period of 8 months is 1,33,333. So once you cancel that depreciation, or you subtract that depreciation from the original cost of the asset, that gives you 18,66,667. That is the book value of that specific asset for the year 2013. Now, when we speak about the next year's depreciation, we have to calculate depreciation for 12 months, but at the rate of 10% on this closing balance, that is 18,66,667, is the specific value on which you will be calculating the depreciation, as this is the written down value method. Had it been that this was a straight line method, you would have had a fixed cost of depreciation, or rather a fixed depreciation amount, if at all the tenure was for 12 months in the first year of purchase. However, this is a written down value method, so whatever is the book value for the previous year will be used for calculation of depreciation for the next year. Let's figure it out. So if you can see, even for the year 2014, we have done the calculation for machine 1, whereby we have figured out that the depreciation at the rate of 10% here is 1,86,667. If you subtract this from the previous year's closing balance, or rather the book value of it, you get a total of 16,80,000 here. So 16,80,000 is the balance of that specific asset at the end of 2014. Now, whoever asks you the questions, or if anyone asks you the question, what is the balance of that specific asset, or what is the value of that specific asset at the end of year 2014, this is the value of it. So this is the book value. Now, for the next year depreciation calculation, you will be using this specific number itself to calculate 10% rate of interest on it. Now, as you know that this machine was sold out in the year 2015, however it was sold out in the end month, or rather in the last month of December itself. So when we speak about depreciation being calculation, you will be calculating depreciation for the whole year, that means 12 months. So 16,80,000 multiplied by 10%, that gives you a depreciation, and after that you will be getting the final book value of this specific asset for the year 2015. This will mark the closure of working of machine 1 itself, post which we'll be going on the working of machine 2. So after calculating the depreciation here at the rate of 10%, we have figured out that the balance that we get for this specific machine is 15,12,000. Now this is the final book value of that specific asset at the end of the year 2015. That means 31st December 2015, machine one has a value of 15,12,000. Post which we'll be doing the profit or loss computation for this specific asset, but that will be in the next sheet. So let's start with the working for machine 2, and then we'll be understanding the working for machine 3 as well. It's a similar format that you have to follow: rate of depreciation 10% on return down value method for the upcoming years. However, in machine 2 we have 2 years to calculate depreciation for 2014 and 2015. So for 2014 it will be the tenure for 8 months, as this machine was also purchased in the month of April. So 8 months for the year 2014 and 12 months for the year 2015. Let's calculate it. So for machine 2, we have done the calculation for the year 2014. Again, this machine was used for 8 months as the date of purchase was 1st of April 2014. So from 1st of April 2014 until December 2014, we have 8 months. So 15 lakhs multiplied by 10% at the rate of interest multiplied by 8 divided by 12 gives you a depreciation of 1 lakh here. So 1 lakh is the depreciation that will be subtracted from the original cost of 15 lakhs, which will give you a book value for that specific year being 14 lakhs. Now, the next step is to figure out the depreciation for the current financial year, that means 2015, what the question is all about. So for that, you'll have to again multiply 10%. However, this will be only for 12 months. So you don't have to multiply by 12 and divide by 12. You don't have to do that. You can directly put out as 14 lakhs multiplied by 10%. That will give you a depreciation of 1,40,000 here. So if you can see, we have done the calculation for the year 2014 for machine 2 as well. For machine 2, in the year 2015, once you have deducted the depreciation of 1,40,000, you have a book value of 12,60,000. That means for this specific machine, the value of it at the end of the year 2015, we have at 12,60,000 here. Let's figure out the same calculation for machine 3. However, for machine 3, we don't have to calculate any more details. It's just the first detail of 8 months that has to be calculated here. Let's do that first. So now that we have done the calculation for machine 3 as well, where the original cost was 10 lakh rupees, and in addition to it, the depreciation was supposed to be calculated only for 8 months. The reason being, again, this machine was purchased on 1st of April 2015. So from 1st of April 2015 until December 2015, we have these totals being matched up here. Now, what we'll be doing is that as the date of depreciation, or rather the total amount of depreciation is 66,667. If you subtract that from the cost of 10 lakh rupees, you have a total of 9,33,333. So that's what you have done here. You have calculated value of all these assets as of December 2015. The next sheet, or rather the next page, will have details about all these things put up in a timeline whereby the book value of all these things are there, and then you add up the sale transaction to each of the asset which has been mentioned in the question, and then figure out whether there is profit or loss or not. And post that, we'll be finding the value of all these assets at the end of the year 2015. So let's go ahead with the sale transaction working now. Whenever you have to deal with a sale transaction working, you already know that there are two specifications that you have to think about: the value of that asset after cutting out all the depreciation on the sale of the transaction or on the date of the sale transaction, and the actual sale price. The written down value of that specific asset is less as compared to the sale price. That means if the written down value is 10 lakh rupees and we have sold it for 16 lakhs, that means there is a profit here. However, if the written down value is more as compared to the selling price, then there is a loss in this situation. So make sure this concept is very clear whenever you have to understand about depreciation, or rather profit or loss computation on sale of assets, be it any asset, be it a partial sale, be it a complete sale. So that doesn't matter. However, what you need to understand is that in both these scenarios, you have to take care of the written down value or the market value of that asset, and that has to be compared with the selling price. If written down value is less as compared to the selling price, it is a profit. If written down value is more as compared to the selling price, there is a loss. So make sure these details are sure about it. Let's start with the sale transaction working for machine number one, because that is the only machine that has been sold out here. Let's do that. So now that we have understood how the sale transaction works, when we talk about the written down value and the other details of sale price as well, let's start it for the machine number one, which was sold out in this specific illustration. So we can see we have figured out the working for sale transaction as well. The total cost of this depreciation, or rather the total cost of this asset, machine number one, was 20 lakhs, out of which the total depreciation that we have subtracted right from the year 2013 until 2015 was 4,88,000. That means we have a total book value of 15,12,000 updated here. This same asset was sold out for rupees 16 lakh. So if you can see, the book value is less as compared to the selling price. The selling price is more, hence we have a profit here. Now the calculation of profit, or rather we can say about the difference between the sale price and the written down value method, or the book value itself, is 88,000. 15,12,000 is one side and 16 lakh is the sale price on the other side. So the difference between them is the profit that we have earned on selling this specific asset. Now that we understand that the sale transaction has been done, the profit and loss computation has been understood, we'll figure out what is the value of the remaining assets, because this asset has been sold out. So we need to understand what is the value of remaining assets that we have in line with our question. So let's do that and then mark the closure of the sum. So we can see we have figured out the total value of all these assets, rather the total depreciation as well, and the total value of all these assets as of December 2015, which is 21,93,333. Machine 2 total 12,60,000, and machine 3 total 9,33,333 has been clubbed together, and that gives you the value of both these assets, because machine 1 has been already sold out, so it isn't in our kitty right now. It isn't in our kitty box. So we'll move it out. Machine 2 and machine 3 are still there. The value of that asset has been mentioned here, and the total of depreciation for both these things have been also mentioned in both these questions. Rather, we can say that one of the depreciation total for machine 2 is 2,40,000. On the other hand, it is 66,667. So that is the total depreciation for both these assets. So I hope this sum gives you a lot of clarity as to how to solve the same kind of problem when there is a complete sale of asset under written down value method. And hence, all these details are clarified to you about calculation of depreciation, the tenure consideration, and how the profit and loss computation is done in this kind of method. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKeda and keep subscribing to eKeda.